grateful. I said, I'm so grateful for God giving us this opportunity to be here in the house of God. Everybody say one more time. Hallelujah. He didn't have to do it, but he did. He didn't have to keep us alive, but he did. And I don't know about you, but I'm just grateful for God for being good. Have I got any grateful folks in the house today? It's certainly not all about us. It's not about us. It's about Jesus. And the reason I live this life, is because I want to see God's face in peace. Anybody want to see God's face again? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. John spoke on the Isle of Patmos. Hallelujah. He spoke about gates of pearls, streets of gold, walls of jasper. He talked about there's a tree in the midst of glory. Say the tree, the leaves on the tree is good for the healing of the nation. I don't know about you, but I'm looking forward to that day when I see the one on the throne. John said, I can't make out the face, but I look at the hands on the one on the throne, and I notice there are nail prints in his hands. I looked at the feet on the throne. On the feet of the one that is there are nail prints in his feet. He said, I pierced around the side of the one that sitteth on the throne. I noticed there was piercing in the side. He said, but I tried to look upon his face. I had to turn away because the light was so bright, I couldn't make out who it was. But I realized I didn't have to know all that I thought I saw and hoped I saw from his face. Just looking at all the other descriptives, I realized that it must have been the Lamb of God. I don't know about you. Somebody say, I'm looking to see my mother there, looking to see my father there. But how many looking to see Jesus? Oh, come on, give God a hand clap if you're going through this thing that you're going through. To see Jesus. My descriptives and John's were only partly what we know about it. But I can only imagine. Can anybody just imagine? Just bring about your imagination on what God is all about, where we see him. For the scripture says, a half has not been told. Put your hands together for Sister Denise Shy as she comes in Jesus' name.
Speak it all.
Hallelujah. 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 I'm so grateful to the Lord that He saved me. And then when I leave this earth, I got a place to go. Anybody looking forward to that day? Hallelujah. 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 And I want to thank the Lord for Pastor Travis inviting us here. Hallelujah. I didn't know that he thought that way about me. And all I am is just a servant of God. That's all I am. God saved me, a poor boy, amen, that God brought out of the ghettos and taught me how to love, taught me how to serve, and taught me how to live and live for Him. And I found out a long time ago that if you are faithful in a few things, He'll make you ruler over many. Can I get a witness in here? Amen. I want to thank the Lord for some folks that followed us way up here. They found out we was coming. Amen. From one of our different churches down in there. Amen. Sister Lynn Robinson. Thank God for her. From the Mount Gethsemane Holy Church. Her pastor down there preached at their church, and she wanted to know where we're going to be and where we're going to sing and what hotel we're staying in. Amen. And she trucked up here. We thank God. I think she got somebody with her. Yeah, her aunt. Bless your heart, auntie. Amen. Amen. Thank God I got a bunch of friends out there, the Hollies out there. Amen. Thank God for them. Wave your hand, Holly. Amen. Everybody. And take the time to thank Brother Widener for and his crew and the staff of this great church. Amen. We're going to move on because we want to just praise the Lord. Is all right, we praise the Lord? Amen. 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 We're going to do a little something. God is my everything. We did a little bit on it yesterday. We're going to do some more today. So y'all got to get with us. Come on, band. All right, come on, choir. Now, y'all got to go with us. Come on. Y'all got to bob with us like this. There you go. Come on, up and down. That's it. Come on. Here we go, choir. Did y'all get that? Now, I want one great big choir to deal with us. Here we go. Y'all got to deal with us. Here we go. Come on. Da-da-da-da. Some of y'all got it. I see little ladies got it. Here we go. Do it again. Go! All right. Now, over there, you a little slow. A little slow. A little slow. Got to come on now. Here we go. Do it again. Do it one more time. We gonna sing the song. Here we go. God is. Come on. God is. Hey. He's my joy. Yes, sir. For He's my hope. Oh, keeper. Whatever it is to me, my leading post. That's what he is to me. I said, can I get a witness? Can I get a witness? Anybody know about Jesus? Anybody know about Jesus? Anybody know about Jesus? Anybody know about Jesus? Put something on your mind. Put something on your mind. Put something on your mind. That's the Lord's done. He's been my lawyer. Yes. That's right. Y'all have a church today. I love it. Here we go. He put money in my pocket. Clothes on my back. Shoes on my feet. Everything. Shout hallelujah up in here. Woo! Hallelujah. I don't know about you. But look at somebody next to you and tell them God is my everything. Tell somebody on the other side, tell them I don't know what he is to you, but he's my everything. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I said hallelujah. I said hallelujah. Woo! Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 Anybody glad that God is your everything? I said, is anybody glad that God is your everything? Then I dare you to give God a great big holler and shout hallelujah. Shout hallelujah. Shout glory. Whoa, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I believe God gonna heal somebody in this place right now. Oh, y'all ain't saying nothing. I said, if you're sick, I believe he's going to heal you today. Hallelujah. If you got a case in court, I believe God going to work it out for you. Anybody believe God is able to work it out? Then touch somebody, shake their hand like you're going to shake it off and tell them, I don't care what you're going through. God's going to work it out for you. I said, God's going to work it out for you. If you believe it, come on, give God a shout hallelujah. 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 We're serving a good God. I said we're serving a good God. I said he's not a dead God. He's not a crippled God. But he's a good God. Hallelujah. So we're going to do it just like this. 1, 2, 3, 4. Through his goodness and what he done for me, he died to set my soul free. We thank you. just a cliche, but I feel like praising the Lord. Anybody feel like praising Him? Has He been good to you? Shake somebody's hand and tell them He's been good to me, honey. He's been real good to me. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Thank you.
feet with us. And we're going to praise the Lord. Everybody, come on. Clap those hands, everybody. To meet folks like you. I'm grateful to meet your pastor. I'm glad to know Jesus most of all. Are you grateful in the house today? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I'm most grateful because I have a sister that's been with us, and I'm just going to say this a little bit about her since we started. God gave me this vision way back in 1996, but he told me not to do anything with this type of ministry that I have, music, until he says so. And we're here today, Michael Chamberlain and the One Faith Choir, by the power of God and the Holy Ghost. Somebody say hallelujah here. I thank God for this wonderful band of gentlemen. That's Brother Wayne Troy Chu on the bass with the pink headphone. That's Brother Corey Wilson on the drums. Amen. Corey went all the way to California from this side now. He's from the East Coast. Went all the way to California, snatched himself a wife, brought her back to the East Coast. Now they got two chilling. Amen. Thank God for Corey. Very gifted drummer. Douglas Barton on the keyboard. Amen. These choir members, a lot of them are from different churches. Douglas is from a different church than mine. And Wayne Chu, Troy, is from a different church. I thank God for this young man. He's not only the music director of this band, but he's also my assistant minister of music at my home church. And when I told him about this choir, he was all in it. And if you ever get to know James, I mean, if you really get to know him, he is the craziest man in all of God's creation. Amen. If I'm not home, he'll leave a voicemail message on my phone thinking that I'm listening while he's talking. Michael Chamberlain. I know you're there listening. Then he'll call on my wife's name, Vivian.
Now y'all stop listening to me and pick up the phone.
Then he'll go, okay, you're not picking up the phone? I'll wait. Dong, 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 dong. He goes through all that, see? He makes all kinds of crazy noises. That's James Jade Goggins. Come on. I thank God for his wife, Margo. Amen. Margo has been with me since we started. She's probably the most exceptional anointed singers that I've ever known. I'm not asking her to sing. Ask her to sing. Well, y'all want Margo to sing? Then somebody get her a stool. She probably don't want to get the stool, but bring the stool up here. She's going to.
If she only sings, just sing a little bit. She had a little trouble breathing, but we serve a God who can do anything. And we are not going to let the devil rear his ugly head and silence what God has ordained and given to you. So don't sing the whole song. But that brother right there, he sang a song that said, while I'm still alive, I'm going to praise you through the good and the bad. So you don't have to sing the same whole song. You don't have to sit on the stool. But you've been given a voice to sing. You travel down here just to sing. So we're going to give God the glory. No matter what. No matter what. We will die in ministry.
In 2013, I was diagnosed with a very aggressive form of breast cancer. And when I left the imaging, the radiologist said, I'm really concerned. And she told me good luck when I left. And I sat in my car and I said, Lord, if you go with me on this journey, I'm going to be okay. But I knew I needed something more than luck. So anyway, after a few weeks, the Lord woke me up one night in prayer. I wasn't praying, I was asleep. And when I woke up, he told me to pray. So I started to pray. And the Lord told me three times in my prayer, speak to the lump. And at the time, I didn't know what it was. They hadn't diagnosed it as breast cancer. They hadn't done the biopsy. I just knew it was something there. I could feel it. And that's how I got to the doctor in the first place, because I felt the lump myself. So anyway, after the third time, the Lord was really emphatic. And so I finally put my hand on the lump and I began to speak to the lump in the name of Jesus. And I told it that it had to go. I told it that if it had gone anywhere else in my body, it had to go in Jesus' name. I said, I want it to be as if you were never here. I saw God do that for other people. I knew he could do it for me. So anyway, after I finished speaking to the lump, my husband woke up. He saw me while I was speaking to the lump. And when he started to speak, I just put my hand up. I had my hand on the lump, and I just put the other hand up to kind of tell him to hold on a minute. So after I finished speaking to the lump, the Lord ministered to me, and he said, this time tomorrow, it's going to be as you say. So I was trying to understand what God was talking about. But God has a perfect way that when we don't understand, he's still true. His word is still true. So I asked God to send me confirmation. So he sent three people to me, and they all confirmed what the Lord had told me in prayer on three separate occasions. So anyway, I went for the biopsy and it came back positive. So then I was trying to figure out, God, what do you mean this time tomorrow? Because tomorrow has already come and I have cancer. Anyway, I trusted that in his providence, that it was going to be set in order, and this time tomorrow it's going to be as I say, no matter how long it takes to manifest. So anyway, I went through three surgeries. I had my breast removed and I had it reconstructed. I went through chemotherapy. I went through radiation. And at the time, after it was all over with, for a while, there was a period where I was able to rest. I didn't have any cancer from what they could tell. Then I started to get a really bad cough this year, at the beginning of the year. And it's funny, when I got this cough, I also had this crackling noise, kind of like Rice Krispies in my, when I breathed, I could hear that. And I knew that was not right. And so I went back to the doctor, and they, before I went to the doctor, I'll just say this. My pastor preached a message called, he said, stay anchored. He preached that in the early part of February. And in the message, it was like God was trying to reinforce to me that there would be a storm, but he wanted me to hold on to what he had told me. And he also said in the message to continue to praise God through it all. And God had given me that all the way back in 2013, to continue to praise him. So I had no difficulty praising God until this year. So this year when I had the cough, they told me I had 3 liters of fluid around my lungs when I went to the doctor. And in the space between your lungs and your chest, there's this lubricating space called the pleural space. And it's only supposed to have a teaspoon of fluid. And mine had 3 liters. So they told me, after they tested the fluid and they took it off, they told me that the breast cancer had returned and that it was stage 4 at this point. So, of course, my mind went back to the message that my pastor preached. I knew it was for me. And I thought, I said, God, I know you said stay anchored, but I wasn't expecting it. I wasn't expecting this. I certainly wasn't. So then he brought me back to when he talked to me. And he said, this time tomorrow. He reminded me that tomorrow had come. Tomorrow is just a word for another day. And he let me see that this was my tomorrow. Everything that he promised me everything that he declared would happen this time tomorrow, it was going to come to pass if I continue to praise him. So I said, Lord, how can I praise you when I can hardly catch my breath? Excuse me. How can I praise you when I cough all the time? But he just continued to tell me to trust him. And the one thing about God this time around, he just dealt with me more in prayer. The first time around, he dealt with me a lot in dreams. So when this time around they diagnosed me again, I was wondering, God, where are you? You're not coming to me in my dreams. Where are you? But he determined he was going to meet me in prayer. And we've had some beautiful fellowship in prayer. God has continued to show me he's going to do exactly what he said. He said to me the other day in prayer, I prayed at home. I was praying at my church. And I said, Lord, what if I don't have enough faith? And he brought to me the scripture that says, now these three remain, hope, faith, and charity. But the greatest of these is charity. And he let me see that even if your faith fails, my love will never fail. If everything in you falters, my love will still be here. So I'm trusting in him. And this is the one song that the Lord allowed me, well, that I would like to minister today, if the Lord give me strength and grace in the name of Jesus. I'm going to come down if you don't mind, because I really would prefer to just be closer to you. Prayer can fix it for you. Prayer is what you should do. Prayer can and it will fix it for you. Prayer is what you should do. And before you let the devil win, go back and pray again. Oh, prayer can fix it for you. Prayer is what you should do. You should do. And before you let the devil win, go back and pray again. I got one verse for you. Daniel prayed three times a day. On him other men would hate. To the Lord that night. He said, please don't let these lions bite. The next morning he got out with a great and mighty shout. He said, who would serve a God like this? Oh, you get in trouble, prayer can fix it for you. Prayer is what you should do. And before you let the devil win, go back and pray again. Whoa. Paul and Silas preached in Jesus' name. Of him they were not ashamed. They threw them in jail and shut the door. Say, don't preach about Jesus no more. But that's not how the story ends. In jail they held a prayer service. The devil got really nervous. At the stroke of midnight, a quake shook those boys free. It was the biggest jailbreak in history.
Bless the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Before we end this service, we're going to have a victory prayer for Sister Margo. Is that all right? I told my brother, my friend, Pastor Moses, about her situation and yesterday. And I said she refuses to let the devil beat her. Said she wants to sing and she wants to be with this choir. In fact, I had written a song for her to lead. And in our first recording, I wanted her to lead the song. And she's going to lead that song, y'all. I want to take the time to say thank you again for all that you've done for this choir and letting us sing in y'all's church. Could you give the Lord a hand clap for you? They've got to get on the road. The bus company's got to, take them back. But I want to take this time to thank all of my choir members. thank the Lord for one, he has ordained me to be my helpmeet, the love of my life for 31 years. And pardon me for being biased, but she's the prettiest lady in all of God's creation as far as I'm concerned. I thank God for my wife, Sister Vivian. Come on, give my wife a hand. Now we're going to sing this and we're going to get out your way.